If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give
you
sight to
the one-eyed. We do so many journeys, so many journeys we have done and done. You end up with sent a mask. Then we can have a funeral when nobody's here. Respect that you and I here. We ain't romantic of it. Whenever time we have anything acceptable, we all be here. I give you my eyes to see, even though you was blind. Me give you my eyes, me and I now. Give you all my eyes.
Up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you.
Time is up. Time is up. We can pull out the night. Hope for real. Thank you. Thank you. 그러면 그 아들이 아청은 아이를 쪼개서 와이
go back to the church. No matter what the church, not church or anything. We can't do
it. Okay. A pleasant afternoon to each and every one. Please, I'm asking congregation to stand. Jesus said, I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand upon this earth. And after worm of this straw, this body, yet in my life I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes behold. It is certain we brought nothing into this world, and we carried nothing out. The Lord giveth, and the Lord had taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We praise God. We praise the Lord. This afternoon, it is a glorious opportunity for me to carry on this funeral service. Why I say it's a glorious opportunity? Knowing that Brother Augustus Deacon Thomas, it is me who immerse him or baptize him. It is me who also ordain him as deacon. And it come now that it is me also who standing over the remain of him, or to see the remain of him put away. I give God thanks and praise for such a privilege. And I'm saying again that before I turn to the moderator, if all the churches into the International Gospel Center realize that I'm going now from church to church with a members meeting, only with the board members alone that is on the church member. That means to say I am on a new jive, and I in the passing off of our overseer, I'm building up a family relationship. And let me say, it come to hand out that I take up the reign of overseer Bennett that pass up. And whether here there are any one of the churches, I want to let everyone know that going through a program, I supposed to know what into the program. I sit and help make up the program. You know, say I'm leaving my house from 10 o'clock this morning. I heard that it's going to be 11 o'clock funeral. No one ever tell me no time. When me reach a road, me here say at 12 o'clock, me couldn't turn back, me go down by Pastor Dave's house and me sit there until after 12, me move away again up here and I sit here for a very, very long time. I don't know no time at all that I should arrive. So I'm saying that I'm having a new thing and a thing that I am called family get together. So at this time I take this as my greatest Passover to our dear evangelist Manning, who is a part of my ministry and who is a part of setting up the term inside the program and the everything. My evangelist Manning, in Jesus' name.
We worship the Lord.
Praise God.
We worship the Lord.
Praise God.
Praise God. Praise God. Well, praise God. Our first opening song. Praise God as you have your song sheet. Our first opening hymn, To Canaan Land, I'm on my way.
To Canaan Land, I'm on my way. See you.
Righteous God, Father, and King, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, this afternoon, divine God, we approach you before your mercy seat. Lord, we come give you thanks and praise for your Son that you lent unto us. It pleased you and seemed good to you, O God, to call him back home unto you at this time. We thank you, Lord God, for the days, the weeks, the months and years that you lent him unto us. We thank you, Almighty God, for allowing us to stand at this time, O God, paying our last respect. And I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you take each and every one that he leave behind in definite charge. Pray, O God, that you comfort everyone's heart and allow everyone, Father, to look forward, knowing that your coming is at hand. Hear our cry, answer our prayer, while I look to you and ask it all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
We bless the Lord. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Our first lesson will be taken from 1 Corinthians 15, reading from 50 to 58, and it will read by Opa Thomas Dot. The first lesson will be done by Opa Thomas Dot. In that bright city, I'm not afraid to die.
Therefore, my beloved Christians, be ye steadfast and moveable, always abundant in the work of the Lord. For as much as we have known that your labor is not in vain, here's a portion of God unworthy and at the same time.
Thanks be to
God. Praise the Lord. Praise God. With no other selection done by Patricia Thomas, sister. And then the second lesson will be done by Ariana Lewin and Lila Tomlin's granddaughter. Please come in that order.
Praise God.
Praise God. Patricia Thomas, sister. We move on to the second lesson, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from 13 to 18, and this will be done by Ariana Lewin and Nyla Tomlinson, granddaughter.
Shout a hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me hear a shout a hallelujah. Let me hear a shout a hallelujah. Wave those hands and shout a hallelujah. A hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God, I do believe that we are in a homegoing service. Bless the name of the Lord for our dear Deacon Thomas. Bless the name of the Lord. And for those who know Deacon Thomas, he's a man that always worship God.
Praise God.
Even though his eyes is blind, but when he come to church, he worship God. Bless the name of the Lord.
Praise God.
Bless the name of the Lord. I want to give condolence to the family member. Bless the name of the Lord. And I want to encourage you from the word of the Lord. The Bible said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Bless the name of the Lord. I want to acknowledge the presence of our dear senior pastor, Pastor Dallas. Bless the name of the Lord. And our bishop and prophetess, M. Russer. Bishop Davidson, bless the name of the Lord. We had Bishop Ricketts, Overseer Simmons, and all you. I want to welcome you in the presence of the Lord. Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Bless the name of the Lord.
Praise God.
We are going to continue with our program. And so for those who know our dear brother, you'll hear him sing, White Robe, White Robe,
yes,
White Robe, I'm waiting. Our program this time, gonna invite the Thomas children. Are they here? The Thomas children?
Praise God.
You're here.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Second lesson come to us from 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. As I begin, but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that he sorrow not even as others which have no hope.
For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also with sleep Jesus will God bring with him.
For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first.
Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore
comfort
one another,
with these words.
This portion of God's own words and by saying thanks be to God.
Amen. Shall we praise the name of the Lord?
Praise Him.
Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Praise God. We are here to comfort, as the writer said, one another with these words. He which are alive and remain, we will be caught up to meet the Lord in the here. Bless the name of the Lord. Our deacon, we know for sure that he is at a better place. Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Praise God. We're going to continue with our program. Myself and our dear evangelist will be called Austin. Praise the name of the Lord. Ashley Benjamin, are they here? Brother? Ashley Benjamin. Ashley.
Praise God.
Bless the Lord.
Praise God.
Shall we praise God?
Praise God.
Right, we're going to call it this time Patricia Thomas, sister. Worship God, Lord.
Praise God.
Worship the name of the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Praise Him.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Well, I'm here to send off my brother. I am so tired and everything, but I'm just going to sing two songs. But first, I'm going to sing, don't hear my burden if he. And the road seems rough at times, and sometimes my feet get weary and me so slow. But a brighter days are coming when my Jesus I shall see. Lord, I won't have to worry anymore. been going nowhere. And when my son died, God gave me a comfort, I would say.
Yeah.
Shall we praise God?
Praise the Lord.
Shall we praise the name of
bless
the Lord?
Bless the Lord.
All my life he has been faithful.
Amen.
So we know in a time like this the Lord is with the family. And so we pray that you will take heart and continue to trust him every step of the way. Shall we praise God? We're moving along with our program. Ashley, Benjamin, are they here? Ashley.
Praise God.
Ashley, Benjamin. All right, we'll move on. Thomas Children. All right, we're going to go right into a tribute. Thomas Children. Praise God.
Shall we praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
We worship the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We worship the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. First, I must greet the Holy Spirit of God, who is the head of my life. And I greet from the restroom to the pew.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, before my father passed away, my deacon is the Sunday. She gave me the word. She said, God said, expect death. And I said to her, yes, I expect it. I was preparing myself for it because I see it coming. And the Bible tells you so that death is sure. We praise the Lord. We worship the Lord. We worship the Lord. And at this moment, I would just like to dedicate this song to my father. My heart can sing when I pause to remember a heartache here. His blood has kept him cold along a trail. Thank you.
God called me home. Bless the name of the Lord. What a beautiful day when we eyes behold the city. Oh God, the writer said with joy. We have to just carry on. Bless the name of the Lord. Better days are coming by and by. When we reach the city in the sky, sorrow will be over. Joy will come at last. Better days are coming by and by. Praise God. We're going to move along. We have a tribute by Wesley Benjamin, brother, followed by a selection from the Ashburn Store Primary and Infant School. Praise Please God. Come in that order.
Bless God.
Wesley Benjamin.
Praise God, praise God.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Blessed good evening.
Good evening.
Just gonna call for a backup. I don't remember the song. So I'm gonna call for a backup. Yeah.
Hold on
Jesus. I can remember 2 days before my brother passed off. I was at the hospital with him. He was sleeping because I was waiting for the doctor for updating him. And while he was sleeping, he was saying, Satan, I'm cursing you, you're gonna burn in the fire. You and your angel is gonna burn in fire. Me and my God is gonna burn you. So I walk towards him and I look and I find out that he's sleeping and I touch him. I say, my brother, hold on to Jesus. I said, hold on to Jesus. And while I told him, hold on to Jesus, he said unto me, just remember God brought.
Oh, To be praised, and we are to lift up the name of Jesus. A country where no twilight shadow deepen, and ending days where night will ever be. It's a city.
Shall we praise God? What will it be when we get over yonder? When we meet our loved one and grow Christ forever? Bless the name of the Lord. Beautiful singing. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Asburn Store Primary and Infant School. Are they here?
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
We are here from the Osborne Stewart Primary and Infant School, and we are here to support our dear sister, Miss Opal Thomas. Now, as a family, when one person mourns, we all mourn. And so today we are here to give her our support. I want to say to the family that yes, you are mourning, but I don't want you to mourn as if there's no hope. The Bible tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. And so I want to wish for you that joy in the morning. Now we will be singing a song, and as you listen, I hope these words will comfort you.
Many times in my childhood, I traveled so far. By nightfall, weary, I grow. Father's arms would sleep around me, so gentle, he said. Oh,
praise God.
Bright robe, say bright robe, bright robe, await me there. Shall we praise God? Bless the Lord. We had a late start and we must have a word. I'm going to ask for those who are coming. If you have two verse, I'm going to ask that you just do one. All right? Because we must be out of here before time. We're going to go right into our selection. We have a grand selection by grand and great grandchildren, followed by combined choir. And after the combined choir, we're going to have the word of comfort. Praise God. Grand and great grand.
Praise God. Bless the Lord.
Shall we praise God? Shall we praise the name of the Lord? Praise God before the combined choir come. Bless the Lord before they come. We're gonna take four more tributes and then we're gonna go right into the sermon. We will break and then we'll get back to the program. At this time, I'm gonna call Wesley Benjamin, brother. Wesley Benjamin.
See, since this evening, I haven't heard anybody come up so far that really portraying who that man was. And he's my brother, but he's also my father. And I had a couple of fathers. But he's one of them that always be there for me, growing up in my tender age, you know, my infantry age up to 12. A lot of things my brother taught me to do. Cooking is one of them. Oh, until now I still have a problem with some women because when I cook, they're scared to go to the kitchen. And it's because of this man. You know, at maybe the age of, I was maybe 10, 12 when Sweet, his daughter with Juliet was born. And my brother used to coach me through the whole thing about pregnancy at 10, 12, right? He showed me everything and I was a man with a lot of curiosity from growing up. I want to know everything. So I would ask him, how does baby come about? And he would walk me through the whole thing at 11 and he would say, you can't say anything to your mother and father, but since you asked, I'm going to let you know. And when Sweet was about to born, he actually tell me, that's Opa, known as Opa in Thomas. He actually said, I'm going to leave the door crack so you could peep. And I'm like, if they catch me, it's going to be a problem. He said, don't worry, no one will be there but me and whoever. I tried to, but eventually she was born at the hospital, so I didn't get to the hospital. So Gussie taught me a lot of stuff. At the age of 5, I remember I was so close to him. Everywhere he went, I would be on his back, or he had me in his arm, or over his neck. And Rosie, that's the first kid's mom, they were outside cooking in a little small kitchen, you know, the wood fire thing on the floor. And my father had a shop, as many of you already know, up in Mokole. And there was some argument with other people fighting in the front. Just a story with Gussie. And he left me in the kitchen in the corner. And he said, don't move, don't move. And I'm like, okay, I was maybe 5, 6. But he left too long. So curiosity, I was running out and I fell. And I was going headway down in the soup. I remember he said, put your hands first when you're falling. So I put this right hand and it was cool all the way up here. Yeah. Even though the noise was out there, that's how much he knew me. He could hear the little tiny screaming, ah! He was the first one to get back and to grab me. The hand was like snow. The doctor wanted to cut it, but he said no. And my father, they pushed me through. Then Gussie way back. With my schoolwork, it's Gussie. But he was playing some trick with me, right? I never used to love to go to school. I don't like school. Maybe at the age of 12, Wendy was hiding by the house down there with Uncle Tom. Yeah. Me and Richard. Yes. And my other cousin would say, we're going to play police and thief today, man. We're not going to any school. But what Gussie did, he was so much touched by me, and I was touched by him. He was scared to even discipline me. So he set my other brother just up to deal with that discipline. And he would stay around the corner and tell us what to do, where we're going, where we're hiding. And when I come back crying, he hit me. He said, oh my God, I'm going to talk to that boy. Then I catch him one day saying to us, you have all right to cut it. That boy needs to go to school. That was my ear if I start picking up on my schoolwork. So Gussie have been everything to me. It was difficult even getting here based on the job policy. But it was debt. I have to take it up to higher levels to get the time out. Even to sign documents saying that I will quit if they don't give it to me. I was luckily the head director of HR approved the leave. And they also approved 5 days from it for me. So I'm here for a week to deal with this with Gussie. But I have a lifetime to deal with this for Gussie.
Yeah.
His name, his spirit resonates in my soul for a lifetime. Just like my father or any other one of my siblings. But there's a special touch for Gussie because he showed me the pathway down to life. Things that I'm living by today. I have a few tributes. Let me cut this short that I reach out to some of the family members. And I just want to play a few that asked me to play for them because everybody hear me talk so much about it. I'm going to be selective, but I already let them know it's too much. Yeah. So let me see who is this. I played the first one from Una Morgan, right? She's a member of the Morgan family, which is our family. Yeah, all Benjamins and Morgans are family. Thank you.
Sometimes we don't spend enough time with each other. If there's anything that we have learned out of this pandemic, is that one, we can all live with less than what we work so hard every day to work hard for and to support our families. And number two, the second thing that we've learned is that we have to learn to celebrate each other while we are here, alive in flesh. I myself is guilty of it too. My family, my loved one. Wayne, stand strong. Long live the Benjamin family forever. It's the root from whence we all came. Blessings.
Good. Understand that the Power of Faith ministry will have to leave, and so I'm going to give them the opportunity to come, and the next voice will be the combined choir. Then you will have the sermon for today. I'm going to ask that you come in that order. Power of Faith ministry.
Church, we send greetings in the mighty name of Jesus. If I carried the gospel to the lost, near and far, I won't stand empty-handed at God's judgment.
Word alone to hear my
Savior, save. And when my life and earth has passed, there is one thing, Lord, I ask. Please don't let me leave the earth and not minister. If I am wrong, a brother, if I am wounded, a friend, give me courage, precious Lord, to make amends. And when I've come to change the world,
the combined choir to come. Combined choir. Combined choir.
Yeah.
Shall we praise God? At the midnight cry, we will be going home. I did send the voice that you will be hearing. Next will be the sermon, but before I'm going to call the City Light Mission through Faith International to come with their tribute, with their selection.
Lord, everybody.
Praise God.
Amen. Praise God, everybody.
Praise
Come
God.
On, give God praise just a one more time.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give Him praise.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let me, amen. Firstly, wish my family. It is today I found out dearly that we are related. I didn't know. And I see why I love Deacon Thomas so much and didn't understand that it's blood of our blood.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. And henceforth he has his death wish was for me to do the service. Yes. But we just want to sing today. He was at my consecration service as a bishop. Amen. He was at everything that held at City Light Mission Through Faith International. This man, though he were yet blind, but he was always there, even at our baptism service, he was there very early. And so forth, we're here to do our last respect. Amen. I love him. Amen. Thus far, and I pray, I know that this man is resting in the arms of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, give God praise everywhere.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. And we have to be the light in what we do. And as a bishop, glory to God, we can't exercise over exercise our powers. Right? So we're just going to do this song and this song.
In the dark of the midnight, have I only hid my face while the storms howls above me? Keep me safe till the storm.
Keep me safe.
say to the storm passes by.
Congregation to please stand. Praise God. At this time, I'm going to take it as my greatest privilege and in the service to our dear Bishop C. Davidson, who will be bringing the word. Amen.
Can we just lift our hands and praise the Lord? The believers in the house just worship the name of the Lord. Come on, can we give the Lord a shout of praise? Come on, can we magnify the name of Jesus? Come on, just worship the name of the Lord. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be magnified. Hallelujah to God. He's worthy to be glorified. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Glory to God. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. Bless the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Can we just magnify the name of the Lord another time? God is good. He is great. He's awesome. Hallelujah. He's powerful. Bless the name of Jesus. And He is, glory to God, our comforter. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of the Lord? Can we just lift our hands and praise God? Glory to God, hallelujah. I must honor the Spirit of God who is the head of my life. Hallelujah to God. I want to greet and salute our senior pastor, Pastor Dallas. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? I must salute and greet Pastor or Bishop and Prophetess Prophetess Russell, shall we bless the name of the Lord?
Praise God.
Our moderator, Pastor N. Davidson. Glory to God, Evangelist Cunningham, Evangelist Manning. Hallelujah to God, Bishop Ricketts, all the other officers. Praise God, and members. Glory to God, the bereaved family. Well wishes, praise God, musicians. I must extend to you a heart of greeting in the mighty and in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, our soon coming King. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of the Lord? Come on, worship the name of Jesus. Praise God, we are in the Thanksgiving service for the life of Augustus Thomas. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? Known to us as Deacon Thomas. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of the Lord? I must, on behalf of the ministry, extend, praise God, our sincere condolence. Hallelujah to the bereaved family. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? We do share your pain. We know it's not an easy path. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? But we are trusting God today that the God in the mountain, He is still God in the valley. Praise the name of Jesus. He is our rock. Hallelujah. He is our shield. Hallelujah. He is our butler. And He is our hiding place. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? There's no way I could continue without acknowledging Pastor Brooks, who is the host pastor here. Shall we bless the name of the Lord?
Praise God.
I was informed this morning that Evangelist Brooks, his wife, glory to God, took sick. Bless God, and she was rushed to the hospital. I trust that we will keep her in prayers. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? We know that there is nothing that is impossible with God. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? Praise God upon hearing. Bless God of the passing of our Deacon Thomas. I tell you, it has been an uphill battle. Praise God, since November of last year. Praise God, we had our convention in Treadlight. Hallelujah to God, Deacon Thomas was there. Hallelujah to God, and I'll give you some more details later on. Praise God, after our convention, it was our senior pastor's convention at Goshen. Bless God, and in the height of that convention, hallelujah to God, we lost our overseer Bennett. Yes, hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. Shall we bless the name of Jesus?
Hallelujah.
And since that time, we have been losing, praise God, people who are really dear to us.
Yes,
people who we love, people who we cherish, people who we desire, hallelujah to God, to live as long as God would just lend their breath. So it has not been an easy path for the body of Christ. Praise God, but we stand upon the word of God. The writer said, my hope is built on nothing else but Jesus' blood and righteousness. The writer said, I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only lean on Jesus' name. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? So upon hearing that our deacon passed, our dear evangelist Manny called, and she said, glory to God, Bishop, I was calling earlier because I was at the hospital and Deacon wanted to talk to you, bless God, but unfortunately I missed that call, bless the name of Jesus. And so for the grave digging, glory to God, persons would have expected, glory to God, to see me. But I must report to you that our dear Deaconess Coleman's daughter, praise God, passed. She's from the head church in Freetown. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? And I was asked, glory to God, to participate in that service. And as a result, I was unable to make it to the grave digging. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? Our dear Deaconess Coleman lost also her sister in the process. So it has been a rough time, not just for glory to God or Deacon's family, but all of us as family. We are being touched by, glory to God, this wicked enemy called death. Shall we bless the name of Jesus?
Hallelujah.
Shall we bless the name of Jesus?
Hallelujah.
because of the love that I have for this man laying in the casket. That's why I'm here today.
Amen.
Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? I was only informed rather this morning that I would be the one speaking. So we are understanding that there are certain things that are not organized, but we are trying to make strides. And even as the ministry is going through a shift, praise God, we are trusting and believing God, praise God, that all things will work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to the purpose. Some years back, and if I'm not mistaken, I do believe he accepted the Lord after one of my ministries in the Word. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? We have a very special connection. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we bless the name of Jesus? As a leader in the church, hallelujah to God, growing up, glory to God, all these years, I have observed him. And as was rightly said by Bishop Ricketts, he is indeed a worshiper. Come on, Church of the Living God. He is indeed a worshiper.
That's right.
Hallelujah to God. He loved Jesus Christ with all his heart. Ah, God Almighty, I don't want nobody to tell me what he used to do. I'm not interested in his past, because he has become a new creature.
Oh,
all things are passed away.
Behold,
all things
become new.
Holy Ghost, I become new. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? I know him as a servant of God.
That's right.
Come on, Church of the Living God. He has shared his testimony with us on more than, God, numberless occasions. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? And can I tell everyone today that the testimony that he shared was a testimony that always stirred the Church of God? It doesn't matter how the service is going. One speaker tells us what the mic.
That's right.
Ah, God Almighty, he will draw for some song.
Yes.
Hold him up, Zion.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He always had an encouraging word for me. He said, Pastor David, so me love you.
That's right.
Uh-huh. Me love when you preach. Because the word connect. I feel every word. So there's not a meeting that we have met. Nothing is as important to me as socializing with my members. Ah, God. So I will sit where he is. He's always at the front bench. He can't tell us the love on the back.
No.
Right here, sir.
That's right.
When he come in. Alright, yes, I sit down. Yes, man. When church over, we find him. We talk and we chit chat for a bit. He always encouraged me as a young leader to do the good work. I and to keep the ministry alive. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? He was a very kind person. Easy to talk to. Down to earth. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? He was very friendly. And a lie, may I tell?
No.
It don't make sense to come a funeral, don't tell no lie.
True.
Cause lie now go help if you reach up there. The reality is the reality. Come on, church of the living God. Come on, church of the living God.
Ah, bless God.
Deacon Thomas was visually impaired, but that did not affect his worship. It did not affect how he moved in the church. Ah, can I tell you, when the Holy Ghost starts to move through Deacon Thomas, he don't need nobody if you're holy. Oh, God Almighty. Defines his commitment as a man of God. Come on, church of the living God. Hallelujah to God.
Hallelujah.
I was happy to have met him. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? When he came to Treadlight in November, he was not feeling well. We had to break the convention. Not to evangelist, man. You know, we had to break the convention and had a word of prayer with him. And after that, we served him a hot cup of tea. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Can I tell you, in October of last year, we had a very important meeting at the headquarters church, and Deacon Thomas was there. Not true, Zeki? And he voiced his opinion. And he said, oh, God Almighty, that would have been the last time we met with Overseer Bennett. Yes. God, in October and in November and then December, she passed, and Deacon was a part of that meeting. When we started discussing matters with the ministry, there was a particular church in question, and Deacon said, Overseer, we have to keep the doors them open.
Yes.
It don't matter what the cost.
Yes.
We can't afford for the church to be closed. Can I tell you, it's not easy to run ministry in these times.
Yes.
Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Not everybody will agree with your principles. Hallelujah. Ah, bless the name of Jesus. But we have to stand up on our watch. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? He voiced his opinion. And you know what I loved about him? He spoke with such passion. Whatever he expressed was with passion and sincerity. And so, it is extremely difficult on one side. But on the other side, I'm very happy that I'm here to pay my last respects. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? Come on, lift your hands and give God a praise. Come on, shout hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. We are here as a part of the church family. Bless the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. We're here with the church family. Some are not here, but we give God thanks for those who are. Just to celebrate the life of this awesome man of God.
Amen.
A life that is well lived for God is worth celebrating. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? And so, as we are in the presence of God, we are trusting that the family will find comfort. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of the Lord? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? We are here to surround you with our love. We are here to surround you with our faith. and we're here to embrace you with our prayers. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? That is something that affects all of us. And one thing I know for sure is that when death strikes, it does hurt.
That's right.
Not you.
That's right.
If you hear about someone who has passed and that person laughs, it is because the death is affecting them emotionally. But every single one of us, when we are faced with death, shall we bless the name of Jesus? We do feel hurt. We are broken, we are sad. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? It no matter how much flowers we get, it no matter how much words of comfort we get, it doesn't matter the songs that we sing. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? That hurt is always gonna be there. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of Jesus?
Hallelujah.
And as a result of the hurt, there is so much sorrow that we have to deal with. Come on, lift your hands and worship Him. As a result of the loss that we are experiencing, shall we bless the name of the Lord? Shall we bless the name of Jesus? But as I heard our moderator, she used one of my scriptures that I want to encourage the body of Christ with. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Jesus said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? Shall we worship the name of the Lord? The death will cause us to hurt, but rest be assured today that there is comfort in Jesus Christ. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? Shall we worship the name of Jesus? We have a helper who is Jesus. We have a comforter who is Jesus. We have a restorer who is Jesus. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? And so even as we mourn today, we will not mourn as those who have no hope. Bless the name of Jesus. Because Deacon Thomas knew who Jesus was. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? He loved to sing the song on the other side of Jordan. There is rest for you. Shall we bless the name of the Lord? Shall we bless the name of Jesus? When John the Baptist was beheaded, Jesus took himself to a solitary place and he mourned on his friend's behalf. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? But somebody said weeping, hallelujah to God, may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. I'll turn on the high of one must say, I saw a new heaven and I saw a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth was passed away, and there was no more sea. There will be no more pain. There will be no more suffering. There will be no more crying. Because the former things are passed away. I am anticipating the day when Jesus shall return. Yeah.
start. It is only a finish.
That's right, that's right.
It is only a finish, you know.
Yeah.
You think you got business if you want in a ministry of much years? I hope you have a finish your ears.
That's right.
So they can start good.
Yeah.
And based on what I'm hearing, I'm believing that he ended it good. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? To condemn him, because we have a church who is Jesus Christ, who is going to charge the name of Jesus. I'm here to worship and to give God praise for the life of Deacon. God bless the name of Jesus. I come to support the family. I come to help him. Your strength, I'm a very present help in the time of trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea, though the waters roar and be troubled, and though there is a great swelling.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is my redeemer, he's my strength, and he's my shield. Said, I will not leave you comfortless. I will be your strong tower. I will be your refuge. I will be your rock. Lean on Jesus. Family member, lean on Jesus. The things of this world will grow strangely dim. But a life that is well lived for Jesus Christ is worth celebrating. Start a business. When they start, the big hard. Bless the name of Jesus. So we have to know that our anchor holds and grips the solid rock, which is Jesus Christ. A person who is starting a business, they make a lot of sacrifice. They invest. They borrow a loan if they have to. Bless the name of Jesus. Turn up your credit history. Shall we bless the name of Jesus? They go all out to ensure that the business is going well. But then, boom, something happens like COVID and everything goes down.
Yeah.
I know how you start the race.
No.
I know how you finish it.
Right.
So they can't start good.
Yeah.
We see the life, we hear the testimonies.
Yeah.
Shall we bless the name of Jesus?
Right.
And we are believing that when his name is called.
That's right.
Because whether we believe it or not, you know, there's life after death.
Yes.
So for those of us who think that when you die, it just ends there, you have a next thing coming.
That's right.
I am here to let you know that there is life after death.
Yes.
John said, I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were open, and another book, which is the book of life. And if your name is not written in the book of life, where will you spend? So no matter what you want, live for God.
Amen.
Serve God.
Yes.
Trust God.
Yes.
Prove God.
Yes.
Die in God.
Yes.
Make sure when you get by your bed, Because an accident take me out. Gunshot take me out. Make sure that our souls are right with God.
That's right.
Jesus said, I am the way. In your account. I don't care where you live. I don't care how old is your family. I don't business down to my crown. Jesus is the way. I can't take your record, you know. And when me walk far, because some of you are like say, when they stand up before Jesus, oh Jesus, I go ask you about me. He not ask you nothing. John said, listen to me. Tell them I know your works.
Hallelujah.
I know your works. Someone asks you nothing. He knows me. He knows me by my name. He knows me by my character. Let not your hearts be troubled. He believed in God. Believe also in me.
Hallelujah.
Prepare to meet your God.
That's right.
Set your house in order. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
Bless God.
Oh, what a word. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last away. Remember, there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say,
I have known Abba Sister Max for over 22 years, otherwise known to me as Uncle Gussie. Day in, day out, I would visit Uncle Gussie at the home. Sometimes when I go by the house, I would even change my voice. I would say, Gussie, and he would have said, Uda, Tamar. Sometimes I would have said, how am I going to see me, even though I'm blind. But I would never pass Uncle Gustav and those staff. When he was in the hospital, 2 times per day, even though it was 1 visiting hour that they give, many security have problems because they wouldn't let me in. They said only 1 visiting hour. Before Gustav take sick and was in the hospital, I visited him before he even lost his tool. Gustav has done so much for me. He was like a brother. He is like a father. He has done so much, and that is why I have to pay my respect for Uncle Gussie. You have gone on, but I know your soul is resting in the hands of the Lord. When I went to the funeral home after Gustav died, down by Maypen Hospital, when I went to Witten's son, when I saw Uncle Gustav's face, his face was like the radiant sun. I'm telling you, Uncle Gustav has gone on to a resting place. And all I can say to those that have known Gustav, please let your light so shine if you want to see him again, because he has gone to a resting place. I thank you.
That had fallen, it would seem like an ocean to me. If my heart were a window you could look through,
I'm President and Reader, Spirit of God, Deliverers, Bishop and Pastors, and all the clergy, in perspective, Saints of Christ, Reader family, I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Accept my greetings. I'll be very brief because time has been spent. Somebody glorify the Lord. Let me hear you get up out of your seat and praise God. You see, when a man lives for God, you don't come to his Thanksgiving service and be here as if he's a sinner. Somebody glorify him. Let me hear you praise the Lord in this house. Hey! Praise God, man. Nobody have any reason to love him more than me. 10 years ago, he gave his daughter to be my wife. My wife over here. So make me a whole heap of reason to love you. That's true.
I tell you, once you have Jesus on your side, you can make it. So just hold on.
to his unchanging hands. We bless the name of the Lord.
Went up by Morgan, Deborah Morgan.
Legal funeral in St. Thomas. We went there. We are Legal Thomas. We went to Mighty Obey, Legal Thomas, and we. When every time we have anything done in St. Elizabeth, we did not leave our Legal Thomas. Even when it's time to go to the health center for a checkup, it is me, I cancel my work. God Almighty, I cancel my work to bring him to the health. I put my sister to rest the 26th of February. I went back in Clarendon the Monday. I praise God, I went down by the hospital the Thursday. And the Friday morning when I was on my way to work, I get the phone call that Deacon Thomas passed off. And I even have to cut my work short just to reach back in Clarendon. But Deacon Thomas and I have a good relationship. Many times I get the call, is he alone there? I have to wait up there and barely sit. I have lost a friend. A friend that could encourage me. And brethren, I know deep down within my heart pain to know that this funeral is going on and I would not have anything to say. I wouldn't feel good in myself. Brethren, he left a lot of memories that are memories I will live with. So may his soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine upon him. And I know that there is a blessing is awaiting me and my daughter. And I need to attract this.
You hear the bells now ringing, don't
Bless the name of the Lord, praise God. Bless the name of Jesus. Come on, just lift your hands and worship the Lord. Bless the name of Jesus. We are coming down nicely. Hallelujah to God at this time. We will be having Karen Thomas, daughter of the deceased, with the eulogy in Jesus' name.
Born on the 24th of March, 1960, at Stratton District, Moko, in the parish of Clarendon. Augustus was born the first child of the late Mavis Mason Benjamin and Ricardo Thomas. Although he was the biological son of Ricardo Thomas, he was raised by Hubert Benjamin, who is called Dad. He attended the Rock Olive School, and after leaving school, he ventured into farming. Farming was his hobby. He would farm day and night. Although he enjoyed farming, his life was not complete. He was missing companionship. He met a lovely lady and bore two children together, a boy and a girl. He was happy with them, but he wanted more children. Several years later, he met a beautiful woman and fell in love. They had three girls. He loved all his children. They were his world. That's when he felt complete. He was loved by everyone in his family and community. He touched so many lives and tried to help everyone. He began his Christian journey September 29, 2002. He was ordained as a deacon in Rock International Gospel Center. He would walk to church because he didn't like missing church. He loved the world. He loved the Lord. He would not miss an event at church. This hardworking gentleman never thought that he should take some time out of relax or enjoy the fruit of his labor. So the Lord gave him rest. After became ill, he was admitted to the Maypen Hospital. Gustav's condition got worse by the day, and he later passed on peaceful on the 3rd of March, 2023. Gus left to mourn is passing 5 children, 10 brothers, six sisters, 19 nephews, 17 nieces, 13 grandchildren, 3 great-grandchildren, and a host of other relatives and friends. May his soul rest in peace and life perfectly shine on him. We love you.
and going on. Said, what will it be when we get over yonder? Pastor Ed Davidson will be coming, praise God, to do the prayer for the bereaved. Evangelist Cunningham will be coming to do the prayer for the bereaved family, in Jesus' name.
We praise the Lord. We shout a hallelujah. We shout a hallelujah. Praise God. To sit and the rest of the brethren will stand. We praise God. We bless the Lord. We bow our heads in prayer. Eternal and loving God. This evening, Lord, we thank you for what you have brought us through. We thank you, Lord, for what you have said and done. And Lord, as we place the family in your hands, mighty God, we ask you for your covering over them. Those who from far and near, mighty God, I pray you will take fully control. I pray, mighty God, you will give them love, peace, mighty God, to each other. We pray, mighty God, that you will bind each of them together this evening. Mighty God, as we come, mighty God, to worship, we thank you, Lord, for what I've done today. We thank you for the word, mighty God. And Father, as we are about to leave, mighty God, we pray, mighty God, you will go with us. We pray, mighty God, for the family today, especially those who are not yet accept you, mighty God, as their personal Savior. I pray, mighty God, that they will turn their life to you, mighty God, that one day, mighty God, they will see, mighty God, they relative that passed, Lord. Mighty God, you are the God who we serve, and we tell our thanks in Jesus' name.
Bless the name of Jesus. Can we lift our hands and worship him? Thank you, Evangelist Cunningham, for that prayer. Bless God at this time. Bless God when the Erasmus Associates will be going first, followed by the family members. We're going to ask the undertaker to come. Bless God, and we will be traveling to the graveside of Deacon Thomas. Praise God. Can you please lead the charge, Pastor? To Canaan's land, I'm on my way with a soul.
Yeah.
Big up, big up, big up.
Thank you.
can come up.
Can you close that for us, please, Mr. Undertaker?
Go slow, man.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Go down.
Yeah, close him now.
Go down. Go down. No hopping back.
Come on, Junior.
Uncle, please don't.
All right, take a
seat. Uncle, please don't
do your thing. Don't put your mouth on him.
All right, Junior.
Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Bless the name of the Lord. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God, in his wise providence, to take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Blessed be the Lord. Praise God.
My God, I'm going away. 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 I'm
time. My God, how we live.
I'm gonna get you.